Welcome to MJ's Academy. Today we are going to start with a new lesson known as square and square root. This lesson you can do it for IPM exam and also for other maths exams that are known to you. So let's start. Square and square root. When we multiply a number by itself, multiply a number, number means integers, we have learnt it in the previous lesson, then the product obtained is the square of the number. The example is given, when we multiply 2 with itself, we get 4. So this 4 is known as the square of 2. We also write it as 2 raised to the power 2. We have learnt about power of integers. The power 2 is known as squared. So 2 raised to the power 2 is 4. The general form of writing a squared is known as a into a is known as a squared. You can use any other variable in place of a, but generally we write a. So it is known as a squared. We pronounce it as a squared. Here we pronounce it as 2 squared, that is 4. So there is a list of squares here. We have from 1 to 25. These squares should be known and remembered. So let us write these squares. The square of 1 is just 1. The square of 2 is 4. We have taken the example. The square of 3 is 9. The square of 4 is 16. Of 5 it is 25. For 6 it is 36. For 7 it is 49. 8 64. For 9 it is 81. For 10 it is 100. For 11 it is 121. 12 144. 13 169. 14 196 and 15 225. For 16 it is 256. For 17 it is 289. For 18 it is 324. For 19 it is 361. For 20 it is 400. For 21 it is 441. 22 484. For 23 it is 529 and for 24 it is 576. For 25 it is 625. So these are the squares that we should know. So let's move forward. So here there is a technique to find the square of ending with 1. Means the 25 squares that we have to remember, beside them if they give to find a number with where the square is larger, means here they have given an example of 71. Okay, 71 is larger than 25, it is clearly seen. So how to find the square of 71? There is a technique. First write 1 in the units place. So here there is the answer written. So first we have to write 1 in the units place. We have written 1 in the units place. Then the second is, now double the digit in tens place. 1 is we have written it. Now take the tens digit, that is 7. Now double it. 7 into 2, that is 14. Okay, we have written it. Now write 4 in tens place. So we'll write 4 in tens place and take 1 as carryover. This 1 we have to take as carryover and we have to write 4 in this tens place. Now square the digit in tens place. Okay, now take again the tens place, that is 7, and square it. So 7 into 7 is 49. Square of 7 is 49. So add the carryover to it. So we have 1 as carryover. Now add the carryover, that is 49 plus 1, which gives us the answer as 50. Okay, write the answer of 3 at the extreme left. Extreme left, the answer is 50. Write 50 at the extreme left. So So we have added the carryover and we have written the answer as extreme left. The 10th digit is 4 and the last unit digit is 1. So our answer is 5041, which is the square of 71. So now let us solve a question that is the square of 51. Okay, we will solve this with this technique that we have learned. So first, 1 is there here. So we'll take, first we'll write answer. Okay, write the answer here. Answer as dash. So we'll take 1 as unit place, they are given. So we'll take 1 in units place. Okay, let us write clearly. This is this. 1 is there in the unit place. So then they have said take the 10th digit. So now we'll take the 10th digit, that is 5, and we'll double it. So 5 into 2, that is 10. So we have doubled it. So take this 0 and put it in the 10th place. And we'll take this 1 as carryover. So again, in the third step, now we'll come to third step. Here we again take the 5, that is in the 10th place, and we square it. So 5 into 5 gives us 25. Okay, 25 is there. So now we'll add the carryover. The third step is we have to add the carryover. So let's add 1 here. So the answer is 26. Now the fourth step was write the answer of this third step at the extreme left. So we'll write 26 at the extreme left. So we have got our answer, that is 2601. So now there is a second technique to find the square of number ending with 5. We learnt ending with 1, now ending with 5. Okay, find the square of 65. This is a large number, so we will find it with this technique. Now take the 10th digit, that is multiply 6 by next consecutive number. Okay, 10th digit is there, we take the 10th digit and multiply it by the next consecutive digit. So 6 is there, multiplied by 7, because these are consecutive numbers. So 6 into 7 gives us 42. And the second step is now write 25 after it. 25 is the square of 5. So write 25 after it. So the square of 65 is 4225. So this is our question about this concept. Find the square of 95. So 95 is a pretty high number. So with this technique, it is easy to find the square of 95. So the first step is take 9, that is the 10th digit. So we'll take 9 here and multiply it by the next consecutive number. So the next consecutive number after 9 is 10. So we'll multiply it by 10. So 9 into 10 is 90. And this is simple, we got 90, and we'll write answer here. Okay, we got 90 here, and the next step was write 25 after it. Okay, so our answer is 9025. So the square of 95 is 9025. So we have finished with this lecture, and don't forget to subscribe, like and share to this video, that is from MG's Maths and Science Academy. If you subscribe, you are supporting Maths and Science Academy to make such an interesting and new videos. After subscribing, please click the bell icon. Then you'll get all the notifications of this academy. Thank you.